Hello everyone, in this tutorial, I will introduce you with the PLC. As you know, PLC stands for Programmable Logic Controller. Okay, so the Programmable Logic Controllers have in recent year experienced growth as universal element in industrial automation. It can be effectively used in applications ranging from simple control like replacing a small number of relays to complex automation problems. If we go for definition of a PLC, a programmable logic controller or PLC is a ruggedized computer used for industrial automation. These controllers can automate a specific process, machine function, or even an entire production line. Programmable logic controllers have been an integral part of factory automation and industrial process control for decades. PLCs control a wide array of applications from simple lighting functions to environmental systems to chemical processing plants. These systems perform many functions, providing a variety of analog and digital input and output interface, along with data conversion and various communication protocols. All of the PLC's components and functions are centered around the controller, which is programmed for a specific task. If we go for advantage of PLC, that as it is in compact in size, it reduces the space that is required in order to place the panel. Okay. If we go for past situations where we are using relays, in order to control the process, if number of inputs and outputs increases, size of panel is also increases. So here, by a compact PLC, you can control thousands of inputs and outputs. So PLC is energy saving, easy of maintenance, as there is not too much hardwiring. So it is very easy to maintain PLC. As compared to other controllers, it has greater life and reliability as it is known as industrial computer, especially PLC built for withstand the temperature and conditions in industries. Shorter project time, easy storage and documentation. In order to store different variables value, we can communicate PLC with the monitoring software such as HMI and SCADA, and by using HMI and SCADA, we can store the values in database such as SQL, Oracle, and Microsoft Access. Applications of PLC: steel mills, food processing plants, chemical plants, power plants, printing plants, manufacturing plants, and there is so many different applications where we can use PLCs. Modern PLCs were introduced in the 1960s, and for decades the general function and signal path flow changed little. However, 21st century process control is placing new and tougher demands on a PLC, that is higher performance, smaller form factor, and greater function flexibility. So, as we have seen, the advantage of PLC, as here we have seen, it has ruggedized computer. Okay, so PLC has robust design. PLCs are expected to work flawlessly for years in industrial environments that are hazardous to the very microelectronic components that give modern PLCs their excellent flexibility and precision. No mixed signal IC company understands this better than second advantage, that is higher integration. PLCs have from 4 to hundreds of input-output channels in a wide variety of form factors, so size and power can be as important as system accuracy and reliability. Now, input and output devices of PLC that we can connect with the PLC. If you go for input devices, we have push buttons, selector switches, you can see here. Likewise, we have push button, selector switches, limit switches, level switches, photoelectric sensors, proximity sensors, relay contacts, RTD, thermocouples. If you see these things, these are the digital inputs. Okay, RTD thermocouples. This is resistant temperature detector and thermocouples in order to sense temperature. Okay, pressure transmitters, flow transmitters, level transmitters. These are the analog sensors. Input and output devices of PLC. Now, if we see output devices such as valves, motor starters, solenoids, control relays, contactors, alarms, lights, fans, horns, etc.